Hey, it's the Crafty Baker. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys three delicious and healthy picnic food ideas. The reason I decided to make this food is because me and my family are going to be renting a boat and going to Lake Berryessa. Woohoo! Let's get started.
I'm going to start by showing you guys how to make the grilled chicken for the sandwiches. In a medium-sized bowl, pour in half a cup of olive oil, half a cup of ranch dressing, and 3 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce. Don't forget to add in 1 tablespoon of minced fresh rosemary and 2 teaspoons of salt. Let's not forget 1 teaspoon of lemon juice and 1 teaspoon of white vinegar. Finally, add in 1/4 teaspoon of ground black pepper or to taste, and this is optional, but you can add 1 tablespoon of white sugar. Mix it together with a fork or whisk. Now that the marinade's ready, it's time to bring out the chicken. Originally, the recipe calls for chicken breasts cut into cubes, 4 kebabs, but because we're making sandwiches, you will need thinly sliced chicken breasts. You will need about 8 to 12 pieces of these. I find the easiest way to marinate these is by using a big plastic bag. You then want to open your plastic bag and sit it up so it can stand normally on your surface. Fold the tops of the plastic bag down so it's easier to pour the marinade in. It should look something like this. Put the sliced chicken breast on the bottom of the plastic bag. Time to pour in the marinade. This next step isn't anything crazy. You just want to pour the marinade over your chicken and make sure that the plastic bag is propped up so none of the marinade pours out. Finally, zip up your plastic bag and make sure that there's no air in the bag. Massage the marinade into the chicken. The recipe says for you to marinate it for at least 30 minutes. I recommend doing it more than that, for at least a few hours. Here's the chicken after marinating. I patted it down with some paper towels so they won't be too drenched in marinade. I'm going to be putting the meat onto the grill, and by the way, I do have a wood pellet grill, but any other grill will work. My dad's going to help me flip over the chicken so the other side can be cooked. Time to take them off the grill. Ready and smelling delicious. Now moving on to the delicious homemade hummus. In a food processor or blender, put in 2 cups of drained garbanzo beans. Then add in 1/3 cup of tahini and 1/4 cup of lemon juice. Finally, put in 1 teaspoon of salt and 2 cloves of garlic cut into a few pieces. Lock the lid in place and start blending it together. When you drain your garbanzo beans, save the juice because you want to add this to your hummus later so it will get smoother and more of a hummus consistency. Ever since we added that juice, the hummus became much more smoother and delicious. Repeat this process until it's become a delicious, smooth hummus. It's ready! For presentation and to add more color, pour some olive oil over it, sprinkle some paprika, and sprinkle some minced fresh parsley. Here's the beautiful, delicious hummus. Put a lid over it and it's ready to go. Now I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make fruit and cheese skewers. For this first step, you will need a knife, a cutting board, and some type of block cheese. I got the brand of Cracker Barrel, but any other different cheese brand will work. I have white cheese and yellow cheese. And then you will need some small cookie cutters. Here I have a flour one and a hard one. You want to start out by cutting your cheese about 1/2 inch. Then cut into the cheese with your cookie cutter and get rid of the excess cheese on the sides. Repeat this process until you're happy with the amount of cheese shapes you have. For this next step, You will need the cheese shapes that you cut out earlier. And here I have these skewer things, which we'll be threading the fruit and cheese on. And then you will need some fruit. Here I have a pineapple cut into cubes, blueberries, strawberries, and grapes. I'm gonna start out by threading one of the strawberries onto the skewer. Next, a blueberry. Now I'm gonna be threading one of the white cheese flowers onto the skewer. Finally, I'm gonna finish it off with a grape. For this next one, I'm going to be threading a piece of the pineapple. First, you should be very creative with these. Put them in different orders, use different fruits. This will make each and every one of them more unique. Last one. It is finally time to assemble the sandwich. So you will need some type of rustic bread. Here I have an Italian baguette. I decided to add some Parmesan shavings to the sandwich. I just want to give more delicious flavor. I will also be adding some greens to the sandwich. I want to add more color and more flavor. I went ahead and made this sauce that we'll be putting in the sandwich. It goes with the chicken, and its ingredients is pretty much the exact same as the marinade for the chicken. I'll leave the recipe in the description box down below. And of course, you will be needing the chicken that you grilled earlier. I went ahead and cut into thin strips so it's easier to put in the sandwich. Now that I cut my bread in half, it is actually time to start putting everything in. I'm gonna start by sprinkling some of the sauce onto the bread. Now I'm going to take some of the meat and put it right on the bread. Then I'm going to take some more of that sauce and sprinkle it over the meat. I'm also going to take some of the greens and cover the meat with it. And you guessed it, I'm going to sprinkle some of the sauce over the greens. Lastly, I'm going to take some of the Parmesan shavings and put them right on top of the greens. I'm gonna top everything off with some more of that sauce and put the other half of the bread on. I'm gonna be taking some more of these skewers that I used for the fruit and cheese skewers, and I'm going to be sticking them into the bread to separate each and every individual sandwich. Done! Now that I've gotten the food packed up and the towels ready, it's time to head to Lake Berryessa. I'll see you guys there. Here we are at Lake Berryessa. It's so beautiful and calming here, and we're getting ready to get on our boat soon. Everybody knows a little place like Coco. I ever went paddleboarding, and it was really fun. Time to take a break and have some food. This trip was honestly awesome. Delicious food, refreshing air, beautiful lake, cool boat. And it's really good to know that there's a professional captain driving your boat and knowing he will get you anywhere safely. Not only is he experienced in driving a boat, he also kept me safe in the water. I need to go to the bathroom. I'll be right back. This was also my first time tubing, and this was one of my favorite activities when we were at the lake. Me and my older brother did it together to make it more exciting. This was so fun. It's time for us to head back. Bye, beautiful Lake Berryessa. Hope to see you again soon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I really enjoyed putting together this video, and Lake Berryessa was amazing. I hope you enjoyed the foods that I made, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye!